Now I would like to invite the Central Secretary for Foreign Affairs, United Kashmir People's National Party, Mr. Jamil Maqsood, to come and give insight about this Gulmarg operation at 22nd October 1947, tribal invasion in Jammu and Kashmir.
Floor is yours.
Comrades, respected journalists, former MEP, defenders, and political rights champions, I welcome you in today's demonstration, which is marking the 75th flag day when our state, the state of Jammu and Kashmir, was invaded by Pakistani military. We are suffering since then. Every day we are losing our children, our women, our rights. Our right to life has been compromised since then. Each year, we celebrate, we commemorate this flag day to remind the international community and to remind our people that we did not forget what you have inflicted on us 74 years ago. My dear comrades, at the time when the British divided Indian subcontinent into two divisions, the state of Jammu and Kashmir was a free and partially independent country. It was under the suzerainty of the British with the Treaty of Amritsar, 16th of March, 1836. The ruler of Jammu and Kashmir was hesitant to join either India or Pakistan because he felt that the Muslims would not feel comfortable while joining India, whereas the non-Muslim state subjects would be uncomfortable with Pakistan. So under those circumstances, he decided to sign a standstill agreement with Pakistan on 8th of August 1947. But Pakistan invaded, disrespecting its commitment to keep its cordial and brotherly relations with the former state of Jammu and Kashmir. So what happened in our part of Kashmir, which is occupied by Pakistan, very few people have the knowledge of those events because Pakistan orchestrated militancy in Kashmir Valley and everybody knows only about Kashmir. But the people of the Jammu region were divided and the women were kidnapped and later they were sold in the brothel of Lahore in very little money. The young girls were raped and their precious ornaments and wealth was stolen. This was what happened in Muzaffarabad, in Ramlakot, in Bagh, in Mirpur, and in other areas adjacent to Pakistan. And many Pakistani tribes, some from Mari and some from Koti Satya, invaded in our part of Kashmir and killed innocent citizens of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. And many were driven out and they have been living as a refugees in Indian part of Kashmir, Indian part of Jammu Kashmir, since October 1947. And today, when Pakistan has exposed supporting Talibanization in Afghanistan, Pakistan is literally equipping and providing logistic support to the terrorist organizations like Lashkar-e-Tayyiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed, Harkat-e-Ansar, Tariq-e-Mujahideen, and many others in different shapes, with the different flags, and with the same ideology that you have to kill all the non-Muslims in the region. Today, the same terrorists are target killing Kashmiri teachers, professors, lawyers, judges, human rights activists in all parts of Kashmir, not only in Indian part, but in our part, they have created an environment of harassment, intimidation, and killing. Anyone who is silent is safe. Anyone who speaks for his human rights, for women rights, for child rights, for health rights, for right to development, is being targeted by these terrorist organizations which are enjoying the blessing of Pakistani military and its notorious terrorist ISI. With regard to today's demonstration, I would like to demand European Parliament that at least you should try to ask Pakistan to comply with the recommendations of 24th of May 2007 European Parliament resolutions. Also, Pakistan is not respecting its commitment on GSP plus trade agreement. Pakistan is placed under grey list by the Financial Action Task Force because of its ill intentions in the region. Money laundering, terrorism, religion as a weapon against human rights defender is a popular Pakistani policy and popular Pakistani narrative in the social media and in main electronic and print media today. My dear comrades, today our children are suffering, our women are suffering at the hands of Pakistani military in the border areas. What Pakistan army is doing? They open a fire with Indian troops on the other side of line of control. And then these unarmed and innocent people look after the shelter. They bring them to the military hideouts. And there they mark the younger. And later, they force them to marry. They rape them. They are raping our children. Even when we speak about this, they start a propaganda that these people are working for the international forces. These people are working for Jews, Christians, non-Muslims. No, we are not working for anybody. We are working for our people. We are demanding our human rights. Today, when the United Nations has asked that access to clean drinking water is a fundamental human right, our people are depriving that very basic and fundamental need in our villages. We are deprived of health facilities. Our police is controlled by an officer which is deputed from Islamabad. Our financial administration is controlled by a secretary of finance, which is deputed from Pakistan. Our health system is controlled by a secretary, which is deputed from Islamabad. Our entire administration is controlled by the general officer commanding, sitting in Mary, Pakistan. So he is the powerhouse. He is controlling our money, our development, our medicine, our doctors, our curriculum, everything. Today, the books of our history has been banned. We are not allowed to study our own history. We are not allowed to speak our own language. We are not allowed to celebrate our own customs. Our people are suffering from cultural genocide. We are facing cultural genocide at the hands of Pakistani military. The world should remember. The world should listen. The world should know this fact that the people of Pakistani occupied Kashmir are facing cultural genocide. And we need your support. We need the support from everybody, from Pashtun, from Sindhis, from Baloch, even from moderate, progressive Punjabi intellectuals, to come forward and to tell your government to withdraw from Pakistani occupied Kashmir as you committed under the terms of Truce Agreement 1947. You have to comply with your international obligations as a state party of International Convention on Civil and Political Rights. You have to comply with the recommendations, with the stipulations, with the articles of United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights. We are human beings. We are people. Unfortunately, we fell under your administration. It doesn't mean we do not deserve human rights. We equally deserve human rights as anybody else on this planet Earth. You have to stop exploitation of our natural resources, diverting our rivers, producing electricity, and keeping marginalized our people from these rights. You have to provide them. Once again, I'm very thankful to my dear comrades, the journalists, the civil society activists who have joined us in this demonstration today. We hope we will have a great comradeship. We will continue our peaceful struggle for the sake of our people to stop Talibanization, to stop extremism, terrorism in our region. This is our commitment to remain steadfast with our ideology of a united state of Jammu and Kashmir, including Gilgit Baltistan, where the people and human rights activists have been placed under Schedule 4. They cannot travel to other city. If they have to go in the other city, in the other village, they have to seek the permission from the local police station. So these draconian laws must be abolished. And the people who do not subscribe the ideology of Kashmir would be Pakistan, should allow to take part in election, should allow to exercise their fundamental political and human rights under your occupation.
Narin.
So thank you once again, and I would say
नारे लगाए मैं भी लगाता हूँ आपकी
I would tweet Jammu Kashmir Pakistan
tweet Jammu Kashmir
tweet Jammu Kashmir stop terrorism in our region stop terrorism stop